show started. This is another episode of Banter with the Brothers, Quarantine Edition.
Here.
We got a squad in here. Fellas, go ahead. Say what's up to the people real quick before we get the show started. Let them know what's going on. How y'all been living?
You know how it is, man. Same shit. Just a different day. Out here in quarantine. Last of all. Yeah, I ain't got no bars. That's it. That's it.
He said mixtape coming soon.
Inside.
My name's right there. Yeah, so yeah, I can see my name.
True. Yeah, inside, chilling.
Can you see my name?
Guys, can you see my name?
Why is my whole government up there, yo?
That's what you put when you log in.
Just
in case my job somehow finds this video. I'm gonna be like, oh, that's not me.
They're gonna find me. I won't say HR, bro.
I mean, like, I've never met that man in my life, but
who is he?
Who is this nigga?
Hold up, let me change.
He said he was
alias.
In a Zoom full of niggas? No, he couldn't have been.
Wow, look what he puts. Frank White.
I mean,
huh?
Frank, right? Frank Lucas, you heard?
Frank Lucas. All right, so this is the first episode we've been able to do like this. So, first of all, thank y'all for taking the time, hopping on the Zoom call, because we got a lot of shit we need to talk to be, you know, upfront about it. I want to leave it up to y'all. Do y'all want to start with the music debate we've been having, or would y'all like to start with a little bit of life after quarantine? You know, ease into the show a little bit.
Life after quarantine.
Let's get right to it.
We don't want all that smoke at first. Feel me?
Smart man.
That's fair. All right. So, you know, what's everyone's thoughts? I don't think, you know, people have really come to grips with what life is going to be like after quarantine. You know, we never had anything like this. So what are y'all thoughts on when we do get back to normal life again?
What is even normal life, though? Like, you know, what are
yeah,
we,
that's
like,
what I was going
to
ask.
You know what I mean? Like, remember how we used to look at, like, well, I used to see, like, you know, Asian people wearing the mask and shit, be like, what the fuck? Like, is that, like, every day now? We're going to be wearing masks and, like, over panicked and shit? Like, I don't know.
What are we going to be doing with that one?
Yo, vaccine is like, so far in the future, though.
Vaccine, like,
that
not going
to
be.
Yeah. That shit's got to work, bro. Too. Like, it takes, like, a year and a half, 2 years to get that shit developed. And then it's got to, you know what I mean? That shit got to work, you know, after the trial. So I don't know.
The testing process is going to be ridiculous, though. So
I think the solution, though, is, like, testing, though. Like, if you can test motherfuckers and be like, yo, like, we can tell who has it and who doesn't, then you can go back to work. Like, we can isolate.
Yeah.
Those.
I feel like that's mad expensive for somebody to do testing every week.
They have to. That's the only way we can get out of quarantine. If we can test millions a week. Like, if we can get a rapid
test going
on. I feel
like that's not something they're going to want to, like, put the money and funding to, to be honest.
They have to.
I feel like
they're
not taking
it,
like, that serious. Like, when you think about it, you're trying to make a decision. Like, you know, the president and then the House of Representatives on a different – the governors, everyone's on a different type of wavelength. Like, you have to figure out where, like, all the funding is going to get to centralize the effort. But there's no, like, it's not centralized.
It's not going to that.
Because people, it's too many extremes. It's not everybody's in the same, like, Florida. Florida's just open back up for business.
Right. New York's in a panic. I think, you know what I think happened, yo? Because remember when Trump was like, yo, I make the last choice of, like, you know, whether or not the states open up and Cuomo and, like, all the, like, Democrat governors are like, oh, nah, no, you don't. You know what I mean? I think after they was giving him all that hell and shit, he was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm not helping with the test. Y'all figure it out. Y'all want to open up? Y'all get your own test. Y'all figure it out. I'm giving y'all all this shit. Like,
yeah, that's
ego, probably
bro.
Slowing
that's
shit down
so
right
stupid,
now.
Stupid, though, when you think about it. I mean, that's the
he's
type of time people are
now. He's trying to make business moves. He's trying to make business moves as a president, but lives are at stake. So it's like...
Nah, I don't know. I just think they gotta test people, man. I'm comfortable going back to work knowing we're all getting tested weekly and we can tell who the fuck has the shit and who doesn't.
Yeah.
If you tell me we...
Sorry, if they're willing to get tested, if they're willing to open testing every week, that needs... You need to know the results almost immediately. Right now...
Immediately,
like
we can't... Yeah, you can't wait. Exactly. You can't wait that 3 to 5 days. Slow.
Hey, they say a third of people who have already probably contacted it have no idea.
Yeah.
No idea. One of us could have it.
Who feels sick?
Definitely probably
statistically, probably.
I got time for that.
Shit.
Oh, you got it?
Nah.
I was speaking to a nurse that works at Yale. She came into my job and she was talking to me. She said, you know, a lot of people, there's been more recoveries than deaths, you know? And a lot of people who are dying are people with conditions already. You know what I'm saying? So whether it's what she said, lupus, like diabetes, heart condition. Diabetes, yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, certain underlying factors.
Yeah.
Yo, that, yeah. I agree with that. Yo, I was saying that to my parents the other day. They were trying to argue with me because I was like, yo, they I hate when they report like 900 deaths in New York. Like my parents would panic. I'm like, yo, you got to look at what's the situation around that death. You know what I mean? Like what happened in that death? Was it strictly corona, or did this person have like asthma and that shit like inflamed everything? You know what I mean? Or like, you can't just be like 900 people had this. Like, you know what I mean?
You gotta stay off the news. You can't be too news heavy with that stuff, yo. You got to hear like certain actual numbers.
Then again, that's the news job. The news just got to.
Truly. But like, forget about the propaganda.
That's what the nurse was saying to me. She was like, we need to not watch the news too much. Stay informed, but don't watch it too much because they're not doing any good for us. That's what she said out of her own mouth. You know, like she's on the front line dealing with COVID patients and stuff.
Yeah.
So she was like, yo, there's too much panic. And I agree because at the end of the day, people fear what they don't understand, right? So I know the government has information on the issue. They don't want to tell people who died. Bro, you see how many people died in Italy? But them Italians, there's a bunch of old people in Italy, bro. Like,
healthcare infrastructure is not that good. You know what
that's
I mean?
True. Really
like, yeah. So many old people. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Their bodies ain't strong enough to fight it.
Like, I've visited Italy like 4 or 5 times because I have family there. Like, I'm not. Obviously, it's sad to see so many people affected and shit. Yo, maybe going to the girl right now. But anyways,
chill out.
But yeah, no, like I can tell areas that I visited, it's
cooking his chicken. Yeah, you're
COVID there, so.
Yeah, I had to be in Florida.
How is this gonna affect the election?
Joe Biden's not winning.
The people vote about that.
Yeah, me.
It was Joe Biden's not. Listen. Trump is tough, but listen, Joe Biden just. Joe ain't it, though. You know what I mean? Like, Hillary wasn't it, and Joe ain't it, though. Uncle Joe, Joe don't know where he at. He doesn't know where he is.
Hang on, hold you, bro. Yeah. When he was just like, when he was like, yo, this is my wife.
Yeah, and it was his sister. Yo, have y'all seen the video Trump tweeted that was mocking Joe with Obama? Have y'all seen that original? Have you seen the original Joe Biden story? This nigga was like, yeah, the kids.
Why does he have the time to do that?
They were rubbing on my leg and it was white hairs. And it was like,
why does he have the time to do that?
Joe, yo.
The thing is, he don't.
No, no, that shit was funny as hell, though. You can't front. That video was funny as hell.
I didn't watch it because I don't. I see his stuff, bro.
As much as you may hate Trump, that shit was jokes, okay? That man is an entertainer. He knows how to entertain.
Can I just say this one thing, yo?
He's been a celebrity for 30 years, bro. He's not gonna lose the election. It's a popularity contest. He's been doing this, baby.
He's the president. Y'all be enabling him. Because y'all be reacting to
a lot of people are going to be like, why we want to change the views and stuff. Like, even if he's not, I don't know if he's doing a bad job or a good job because we haven't seen something like this.
And even if, like, if you watch CNN, they'd be like, 900 people died because Trump didn't do this.
He'd
be like, hold on, was it really this nigga's fault?
Yeah. He's putting out orders and like he's putting out different stuff. It's our job to follow them. Like I'm not a Trump supporter. I don't pay attention to politics. But from a logic standpoint, if the leader of the United States tells you to stay home or tell you to do this, and you're there, and his like group tells you to do specific things.
Well, listen, though.
Sure that we're safe.
Politics,
we're
gonna, he's not, though. He's really not, though. And his supporters, though,
politics,
he's praising the people protesting.
Politics is not logical.
Yeah, he actually endorsed them.
Yo, it's a tough, that whole opening the shit in is really tough, bro. I think it does have to be, like, the states that have to say, like, we have to, it can't be Trump that says open up. Like, it's got to be the states. Like, because they were saying, like, the Georgia nigga was saying, like, I want to open up because I feel like what our curve's going down, if it blows up, we have enough, like, ventilators, we have enough like hospital room or whatever to do it. He's saying they got tests. I don't know if that's true, you know what I mean? But if they can prove that they can test motherfuckers, then I agree. He was like, if we got enough room for hospital beds. I was like, I don't know.
Y'all want to talk about Florida's governor not knowing what's going on? Georgia's governor said he ain't know like 3 weeks ago that shit could be passed via the via spit, bro. The CDC is in fucking Atlanta. How did you not know?
I want someone to say something, right? I want someone to say something.
Oh, yeah, they open up your Friday. So Friday, are you going to go get a haircut like next week or?
Carl already got a cut.
I already got a cut.
Who cut your hair?
You bro? And he ain't dead.
Don't worry about that. So, don't worry
about
that.
Should we tell somebody? Should we call the CDC?
That's all I'm saying. I'm still not going out. Like I'm going out when everybody's inside.
Is shit normal in Georgia though? Like,
why are you dodging my question?
Hold up, what? You go first. What?
Did he use gloves?
Yeah.
All right, man. Be careful out there, man.
Where did you go? You went to a barbershop or he came to you?
No, I know a guy that knows a guy. You know me.
Oh, my God. So where did you get your haircut?
I know a guy that knows a guy.
This man not telling me nothing.
But, I go to a barbershop, though. On Friday and on, you're not going to go out? You're just going to stay in the house? It's going to get tempting once all your people start
I'm
going
to be
out.
Chilling here. I'm going to be chilling here to like August, bro. You and know how they nice say give it 2 weeks and just see who make it or not? That's what I'm going to do, man, because I don't trust it.
damn.
Like, bro, I don't trust it. Like, I'm going to be honest. I'm going to keep it 100 with you. Like, I'm going to go out when everyone's...
It's a testing period, huh?
Yeah, like, bro.
2 weeks. Yeah, you're going with the 2 weeks.
Bro, you seen a scary movie where there was just like, who's outside? I'm gonna let them go, you know what I'm saying? See who outside, and if they'll make it back, you know what I'm saying?
On another point, though, like, we can't stay in quarantine forever.
I can, bro. I'm chilling.
I'm chilling. I go crazy.
I ain't got no problems. How Dre you say? I ain't got no words.
Yo, but on the whole political thing, right? I think now, you know, some people, they're easy to win over, right? And
of course, bro.
This whole time, you know, if people were swaying or they were in one way or the other, I guess the government knew about this since what, October, November-ish? Like they knew this. They knew this was coming, right? Like, I'm not into politics. They could have did things to put in precautions to maybe, you know what I mean? You know, stop flights earlier from coming back to the U.S. from all corners of the world or whatever.
Yo, do you know what fucking Wuhan did where this shit went out? This shit blew my mind. So the shit would like happen and like the whole pandemic happened in Wuhan, and China stopped all flights from Wuhan into China, like into the rest of China, but all international flights are still valid.
That's fucked up.
Isn't that crazy?
Hey, listen.
Isn't that fucking crazy?
No. Your point, Garfield.
That wasn't that.
Based off of what? My bad. Go ahead. Go ahead, cause I was just gonna say something quick. Go ahead.
Nah. Fuck was I? Shit. But yeah. So they knew it was coming, right? So they could have did certain things to prevent it, like stopping flights earlier, setting up ways to prevent certain things. Now, you know, the president currently, a lot of people gonna look at it like this. Like, shit, yo, this nigga gave me $1,200. Hell yeah, I'm voting for him. Ain't nobody else gave me $1,200. I'm just saying, people are silly. It's not like they're like viewing this political agenda. They're like, yo, I just got free money. Like, so that's gonna affect it drastically, even though it's something you could have prevented from happening. But I think he looked at it and might have think, yo, there's a lot of stupid people that voted for him in the first place, right? Now you're like, oh, I got some other stupid people out here, but this time I'm giving money. You think they're not gonna like that?
Nah, that
for real. I'm still sick.
My fault.
Nah, he's straight. But what I was saying though is like, cause I think the biggest tool, that's why it was like, so I don't even know why America was like not really tripping over this whole coronavirus thing come like November, October, cause they were trying to like, you know, the whole impeachment thing. That was the biggest thing that America was doing on that, you know, during that time. And once they finished the impeachment, everything was done. They ain't find nothing on that man. It's like, all right, now going into the coronavirus. Now the coronavirus is the biggest thing going crazy. And I'm like, not only is dumb people gonna be like, you know, oh yeah, he gave me $1,200. Like, I'm straight. but they're going to be looking at the Democrats like, y'all was so fixed on getting this man out when we could have been preparing ourselves for the inevitable. Like,
I think that's a good point.
That's why I say it's like, it's a smart move on his side. Mad people going to vote for him. Not because of the 1200. It's just because these Democrats was out here trying to get him out. Well, we could have spent our time like really preparing for what was coming, because it was coming either way. It's like we could have been preparing. Forget the impeachment. Who cares who's the president right now? Like, who cares if he's bad or not? We need to be able to protect our people. Like, we need to be able to protect like what's coming, like from what's coming. So, you know, now everybody's all like going crazy over a threat that we knew was coming. So it's like, what was y'all doing in the meantime? Trying to impeach the dude. It's like, it's crazy. But I don't think Uncle Joe can do it. I don't think he can do it.
Yeah, I don't think Joe Biden's it. I don't really
I want him to beat Trump, but
it was nobody. Democrats didn't have nobody that was like legit. I mean, people were mad at me at saying it, but like, if I was to pick someone from the Democratic side who I could say, all right, this dude could probably be president and like get shit done, it would have been Bloomberg. Bernie's not realistic, like the whole socialist thing. The whole socialist thing for Bernie, it's not gonna work. Like, that shit won't work. America's a capitalist society, you know what I mean? That shit not gonna work. Joe Biden is a puppet, bro. Like, Joe Biden really ain't doing shit. Who else they got on the Democrats?
My nigga, Bloomberg is Donald Trump. Just a Democrat.
Bloomberg is Trump and Democrat. Exactly. Bloomberg is Trump and Democrat. But if you were to go and choose somebody on the Democratic side to go against Trump out of the pot they gave you, the serious like contenders, right? Those the serious ones. Because I know Andrew Yang is cool, but like Andrew Yang doesn't have any like, you know what I mean? There's no horsepower over there. You know what I mean?
Donald Trump would have beat him up like a fucking school bully.
Who would you say that?
I don't know, bro. Because he was offering money before Donald Trump. Bro.
He was. Trump is running through the whole Democrats. But if you had to choose, who are you gonna select?
Andrew Yang wouldn't have
he doesn't have the horsepower to take him. No, you know what I mean?
Trust me, I know. But I'm saying he's sitting at home right now. You remember that Soulja Boy interview at the Breakfast Club when he was like, "He stole my whole shit."
That's what I'm saying, though. Like, he really did, though.
That's exactly right. He really did, though. Exactly. That's how he look at. There was nobody, I think, that was really going to win, to be honest with you.
Yeah. I think Bloomberg would have gave him the best run for his money. Honestly. The best run for his money on that side would have been Bloomberg, son.
Bro, and he had the money to back him.
Nigga dumped, like, $300 million in, like, 2 weeks. Like that.
And got zero progress.
He was too late. He was too late. And he's like, now he has, and the tough thing about him is he has no personality. That nigga, it would have been bad. Him going toe to toe with Trump would have been bad.
He was the best option. Hold up. I'll be here.
He would. I think he would have been the best option, yo.
Man, I'm looking for the whole fam right now. Hold up.
Why you keep moving, bro? You good, man?
All right, anyways. So, speaking of life after lockdown, when do you think the NBA, we could say the NHL and like soccer is going to come back? When do you think that's going to happen?
Mid to late summer.
After August.
To be honest with you, I think it's fall. It's fall.
And they're going to be playing with like limited fans.
Fans 2021. There won't be a single fan until 2021. There's no fans in 2020. There's no chance that's happening. No shot, dog. I don't know when it's going to come back, but they're not putting fans in stadiums.
No. Ooh, yeah.
Ooh, they're not putting fans
the basketball
anywhere.
Basketball game this season?
Basketball, it might have to happen because, like, you know, fans make the sport. Yeah. Like, if it's a game seven, like, it's not going to feel the same if they shooting it and it's just –
You're not gonna sit here though. I think that's gonna be more interesting.
They gonna have to put 30,000 laptops in seats to do Zoom. Just have it all in the deal. Everybody sitting there.
Nah, have you seen South Korean baseball? They put like robot fans and they started their league.
Oh shit, for real?
It's hilarious. They put like speakers on them. It's great.
You know what was hilarious? Did y'all watch the WWE during this shit? Have y'all seen the shit WWE was putting out? That shit bro. That shit is retarded. Nigga Stone Cold, I seen the clip. Stone Cold was like, "Are y'all ready to get started?"
No, it was like
he was clowning, bro. I was
bro, was it like Ja Rule when he was like,
"Yeah, yeah, yeah,
oh, y'all ready?
Ready? Guess not. I guess not.
Guess not."
In Florida, yo, AP talking about Florida said WWE is an essential business. What the fuck?
Nah, that's
that was some bullshit. That was some bullshit.
That's Vince really? And Linda McMahon kissing up to the government.
That sounds like some Florida shit. I ain't gonna hold you.
Nah, that is Linda McMahon and the government. Shit.
Wrestling. We gotta have our wrestling on television.
Wrestling. Over.
Carol Baskin.
I can't tell you the last time I watched wrestling.
What?
Since I was
Carol Baskin.
Sixth grade is the last time I loved religiously watched wrestling. That was before I found out it was fake. Once I found out it was fake, it was over. I was like, they're not really hitting each other?
All the fake stomps.
Like, what?
Yeah.
Nah, bro, that's somewhat real, though. The way they do
it was completely real. The camera, nigga, they moved the camera real quick.
The way they do it fake, but, bro, I did. You remember
professional wrestling, bro.
Where he did the thing where he caught the dude by his arms and just pedigree, slammed his face into the
pedigree. Yeah.
Bro, the chair shots. That, when they used to do the chair shots, I was like, "Nigga, how was that?"
Yeah.
I saw him hit him with the chair. Real. It was still just saw him hit him. Like that shit wasn't fake.
It's the way they do it. But like, I did the pedigree to my little brother, bro, and he like his face literally hit the ground, bro.
Bro,
bounced up, and I
that
said,
was the one
professional.
That was the one bad thing about it, because you saw it on TV. You used to be like, "Oh, that nigga's okay. You gonna be okay."
Niggas is stutter all the time, nigga. Right.
You were okay.
Tombstone, nigga.
Bro, I'm my grandma's house. Me and my cousin used to do that shit, bro. Crazy
all day.
Yo, and nigga, when niggas is young, they try to recover from the stutter.
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yo, that Stone Cold Steve Austin, John, bro. I seen that happen like on in a regular hallway.
CM Punk.
All right, my fault. I'm back.
Yeah, bro. CM Punk.
Feed the fam.
Yo, AB was talking about how Florida said that WWE is an essential business.
No, I was listening. That's Linda McMahon. She got an ear in the government. She's on the president's Small Business Council, I want to say.
Yeah.
And they got their operations here in Florida, and the governor here in Florida. Like, first of all, that nigga wouldn't have won if Donald Trump wasn't campaigning for him so hard back when he was running. Because he was running against Andrew Gillum. I don't know if y'all know who Andrew Gillum is. He's a black dude who's running out of Tallahassee. He used to be the mayor of Tallahassee.
That's the nigga that was in the courtroom talking about you didn't do nothing to prevent COVID to the other people.
Nah.
Yeah, he was bugging, though. Gillum was the dude.
That was like Parks or something like that. Parks and Rec.
Oh, did you just change? Did you change your name?
Mm-hmm.
Me? I just peeped that.
Oh,
his name didn't change.
Like Ben changes this. The Wi-Fi really slow today, but
oh, chill, bro. Chill, bro.
Chill, kid.
I ain't see that until really now. Trash. I ain't see that. Nah, it's not trash, bro.
I did see you freeze, though.
It's not trash.
It's okay, Shane. I've been there.
I just peeped that.
Oh shit, Corona.
Hey, hold up now. Hey, sneeze in your elbow, bro. What are you doing?
Right, nigga, can you sneeze away from the camera, nigga? I feel dangerous. I definitely not safe. The fuck?
Let me ask y'all, when is the next time y'all think y'all probably dap somebody up? Like when you see him?
Oh, 2022,
nigga. That's elbow,
bro. All right, New Year's. It'd be like, all right, it's cool, man.
I've been limited for like 2 years.
I hit niggas with this, like, it was good.
Yo, back, even like when we go back to the club, like next year, I'm still gonna be in there. Like, this, back to me, like
yo, clubs are not gonna be open, bro. Clubs are not gonna be
they
open.
Will. They will.
In 2021, they will.
It's too much. 2021?
Oh, okay.
They
will. 2021, they will. Yo,
what are y'all gonna do for like gatherings? Like, what are y'all gonna do? Can't have like nobody together? Like, how does that even work?
I know a nigga's party's dead. The cheeks out here, I know that.
I mean, the chiefs, that's one
thing. You need to get a little portable test. You just got to get a portable test so you can put it on somebody's head.
Hold on, my nigga. What is
wrong with you, bro? All right, you good?
All right, what's good? What's going on with Jesus? Oh, yo, yeah. Your shit red, Buzz. I don't know what's going on with you.
He just started looking, he just...
You better the doctor?
You gonna have to be testing people, taking temperatures at the door to clubs.
Yo, yes. That would be hilarious.
He said, nah, bro. I've been drinking. I don't got Corona. I've been drinking. That's why I'm hot.
End up.
Cough on the line. Is over.
Yeah, you cough on the line, though, buddy. Get off. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Bro.
Hey, bud.
Bro, yeah, have any of you guys sneezed in public since this whole thing happened?
Bro, when I was commuting on the train, I sneezed and people was like,
nah.
I was like, oh, sound good, trust me.
So you know it's allergy season, right?
Yeah.
So the other day, you know what I mean? I was walking out of the train station, I went, achoo. Cause me, I'm the type of person, I don't hold my sneeze. That shit ain't gonna kill me. Like holding the sneeze hurt. Like, so I you know what I mean? You know, I sneeze like this. You know what I mean? If it's like mad random, I can't out of you know what I mean? Whatever. Motherfuckers looked at me like I said, nigga. Best I eat that meat. That's what I said. Look at that meat. Niggas kill me, bro. The train station, for example, right? It's the cleanest I ever seen it. But just goes to tell me something like, yo, y'all be in here cleaning all the time, but you're not really clean, are you?
Nah.
I mean, they could be cleaning. Like, it's just a lot of people.
No, for real.
Like, why wouldn't you clean the New York subways anyway?
It's hard to keep it clean.
The subways? Nah, you know, fuck that.
Like, it's definitely a lot less people now, so it's a lot easier, you know?
They still
don't get me
do
wrong.
Anyway.
I don't think
like,
they, I don't know.
Yeah, bro.
And they
really
like,
need
Sundays,
to clean
they
that,
close
like...
early and clean that shit.
Yeah, right. Bro. They got, they could.
Hold on, I need to get
the New York subways, oh, have... them shits is rough. Them
yeah,
shits
that,
is rough.
That's
straight
piss.
Yo, and
yeah,
rats.
Bro, you go to New York subway, you don't touch nothing.
You don't
dude,
touch shit. You can't help it. But you, when you get on, like, you got no choice but to hold that thing, or you're going to be.
You're
gonna
be
on
that bitch.
I hit him with one of these.
You get everybody gets on the subway thinking like, yo, I don't need to touch the ball, I don't need to hold it. So that bitch throw you. And then you're like, oh shit.
Nah, bro, you really be flying though. You be, it's like,
you know, one other thing I hate about New York subways is when you sit in the seat and somebody like uses the pole right in front of you. So they
man.
The whole, during the whole ride, and you just gotta be, you can't look
you
forward
just
the whole ride.
Looking at
like
them,
this.
You just
you got your fucking balls in my face, nigga. Back the fuck up.
Flag on the plate.
Bro, New York City is just a different animal, man.
It's the last time I was on New York subways, I think the Labor Day parade. And you know, I had a rag. Me and one of my homeboys was there, and he dropped his rag, and he thought about picking it up. I said, "Yo, don't you touch that shit."
It's a
on four, like don't touch that. You're gonna have bumps all over your body. For a fact,
bumps. You have leprosy, nigga.
Bro, tell me how there's this fucking homeless dude by my deli, by the deli over here. This nigga always there. He asked me for a dollar the other day. Bro, this nigga goes, can I have a dollar? I was like, I don't got no change. This nigga goes, yeah, I fucking figured. I was like, what? What? No. I was like, what? Some old rusty ass white dude talking about, yeah, I fucking figured you didn't. I was like, oh, all right, fuck you, nigga. Fuck you. That shit actually got me tight.
Why?
Bro, you better than me. I would have told him to go suck something.
Nah, chill. That nigga fuck around, stab me. I get a fucking. You need to get a tetanus shot or some shit. I can't be going fuck
blood
that
blood transfusion or shit.
Facts. Fuck that shit.
Facts, bro. That's crazy.
Yo, them homeless dudes right now, they probably immune to corona, you know?
Oh, so no,
yeah, man. Years,
bro.
Crackheads. Yo, I saw that shit on Twitter, bro. I said, this nigga was like, if I see crackheads alive and well in 2 weeks, I'm going outside. Fuck that.
Yeah,
well, crackheads are like superheroes, bro. Y'all can't judge that. We regular humans. Crackheads are regular humans, bro.
They're immune
system. Crackhead will walk a squirrel on a leash, bro. You can't.
Bro, their immune system has been battling heroin. Niggas are ready to go. They're good to go. They're good to go.
That's a fact.
Wait, speaking of crackheads, MJ documentary. Should we talk about that?
Awesome.
Oh. Yeah, good.
I ain't seen it yet. I ain't gonna hold you.
You haven't seen it yet?
Come on. I'm sorry. I wanted to watch them all at once. Like, I'm sorry.
No, hand in your black card right now.
I don't want to hear it. Right, I probably already knew everything that was on the documentary and y'all just find out.
Did you know that Charles Oakley was bullying Scottie Pippen? You didn't know that, did you?
What are you talking about? You can look and see that.
Did y'all see Larsa Pippen tweeting about how y'all need to stop disrespecting Scottie because he made plenty of money? And Nick was in the comments talking about no bitch.
Somebody tweeted something crazy.
How's she even gonna say that?
Somebody said, yeah, you must have seen something in his future, huh? I was like, ooh.
Someone signed it to a deal.
That shit is crazy.
What else I not know?
Oh yeah, you said one on one. All right, we'll go. I'll go first. The doc. It was good. I bet you didn't know that Scottie Pippen signed a 7-year contract for $18 million. I think that was the craziest takeaway from that shit. People are talking about Jerry Cross as a bad guy for that. That was finessing. The owner was like, I wouldn't sign this contract. That's not a good contract.
Jordan was getting paid like a mil a year.
Jordan was getting $33 million, bro. That's another fact you didn't see in the documentary.
At the beginning, because Magic Johnson signed a 20.
Yeah, but they got Scottie Pippen to sign for 7 years and $18 million before like the new CBA kicked in and like revenues went up. He got fucked. That was the biggest takeaway for me.
Bro, you got to think, though, that, like, relatively money-wise, like, Magic Johnson signed a 20-year deal for 20 mil. So he was making a
But, like, that was before. You know what I'm saying? Like, Scottie wasn't in those years, though. He was in the years where the NBA was booming, where he should have signed a bigger contract. Like, Magic was playing on black and white NBA. TV, bro. Yeah, they were playing before the NBA was making, like, OD revenue and ad money.
Y'all know that Scottie and them played Magic, right, for the first title. But, like, I don't know.
But there was a switch in the new generation.
Yeah, the evolution
of the league. I get what you're saying. When Magic came in the league, was it even a three-point shot?
You gotta watch that.
What?
When Magic came in the league, was it even a three-point shot?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When Magic first
started? Not when he first came in.
I don't think when he first started.
Okay, then. He ain't paying you.
What did that have to do with anything?
That's a good point. That's a good point. The league evolved into having a 3-point line, just like when Scottie first started. They was paying shit, but it evolved to where it was, you know, making that bread. He should have never signed a contract. I got that. But anyway, the documentary was wavy though. I definitely don't think Carl knows everything in the documentary. I know everything, bro.
That's my knowledge.
Okay? But I think that shit is wavy. I can't wait for Dennis Rodman's part because I know that shit's going to be even more trash than everybody else's part.
He could have his own. He's crazy. Didn't he have his own documentary, though?
Because he's wild.
Yeah, he did, but nobody really cares about 30 for 30. No one cares about, you know.
You're not going to disrespect Dennis like that.
But bro, that's a legend right there.
Bro, did you watch it? Did you watch the documentary? Not really.
I know he's a crackhead. I didn't need to watch it. What is he gonna tell me, like, about the details of his crackheadism?
Yeah, it was actually kind of interesting. I ain't gonna hold you. It was kind of interesting. Cause like, bro,
he grew from five ten to the
Rodman documentary, not the Jordan one.
I said I'm about to watch it all at once.
Bruce Jenner ass nigga. You like
that. Bruce Jenner. All right, you got jokes now. Okay. All right.
Are you gonna let this nigga talk to you like that, bro?
You wanna talk that?
I'll play with you. 10 out of 10 I'll watch the Rodman documentary too though.
It broke the record for most viewed premiere of a documentary.
Yeah.
No one knows anything to do though.
Like
that's a fact. That's a fact.
Of course, bro.
Yeah, that's a fact.
That's my guess.
6.1 million viewers.
That's an interesting guy. He's crazy.
Yeah.
Where is he chilling in North Korea?
I heard Kim Jong Un.
Kim Jong Un is brain dead apparently.
Like he was good.
Wait, what? Yeah, Kim Jong Un is brain dead right now. Apparently, allegedly, he's brain dead. He had surgery and like slipped into a coma. Yeah. And he slipped into a coma.
He's only 30 something. I was like, what the fuck?
That's crazy.
Does he have a son?
No.
That's why I think his the sister's about to be like the one that takes over.
What American doctor did they send over there?
They even got him.
right? Like that. What was that Seth Rogen movie that they had?
The Interview.
Yeah. Interview.
Which is a pretty wild movie.
It is wild.
They banned it for a long time. Bro, didn't they ban it?
North Korea was like, yo, drop that. I dare you. Yeah, North Korea said, drop it. I dare you.
Yeah.
Number one and question they hacked when the studio. North Korea.
That's crazy.
But how are you if good in North Korea, movie, though?
You would have dropped an atomic bomb.
How are you good in North Korea? Dennis, or apparently Kim Jong-un was a big fan of the Bulls back then. Mm-hmm. And Dennis Rodman's the only dude crazy enough to actually, like, pull up and say what's up.
I think you also just needed the Brett. I'm going to be honest. He definitely needed the Brett.
Definitely.
Oh, ain't nobody just going to North Korea just to be going to North Korea. Like,
he did it for even the Dennis Rodman.
No, but out of all people in the world, Dennis Rodman would go to
because
North Korea.
Because the bag, risk your life.
You know, Dennis was like, how much are they paying?
Yeah. That's really what he
said.
That's really what he said.
That's a 20 mil?
What?
20 mil to go to North Korea?
Nah, it was like 20K.
Yeah, ain't nobody paying Dennis Rodman $20 million
ain't nobody getting Dennis Rodman.
Nobody is paying Dennis Rodman $20 million to do anything. No one's paying him that.
It was like $20K. They said on the documentary.
Yeah, not a soul.
The most would be $50K.
The most would be
50K, bro.
And that's to get him to do something
the
stupid
most.
On camera.
The most.
That's the most. That's
the most. And he had to pay for his own flight.
It 20 mil. No
guarantee you leave.
20
bro.
Mil. Kim Jong Un would have been like,
20 mil. 20 mil.
Wait.
It's gonna be like Tropic Thunder.
Y'all seen that movie? I got a serious question. So when you go to North Korea now,
20 mil.
You gotta fly to South Korea and drive to North Korea.
That's a good movie.
No.
Yeah, there's like you might not. But isn't that like how that dude that got kidnapped or whatever?
Yeah.
That's how they did it through the tourism. Like you go to South Korea, then they have like the tours that they advertise for you to go in.
I
understood it to be.
That don't make sense because North Korea and South Korea don't get along. So like, I don't think
border.
You could just.
But like they, yeah, but they allow still, you to go through the border though, through the touring company. Yeah.
But there's a border though.
You can't they fly straight do. Into North Korea. I don't there's think you can fly straight in there.
You can't. I don't think
you can't fly straight in there. You can't
fly to like China and one of their planes can pick you up from China
and go from there. Yeah.
I just don't think you can go south. I mean, yeah.
That's wild.
I think you can go from South Korea. No cap.
I don't know.
That's wild.
They can't because bro, they trade between each other. Like North Korea gets supplies from South Korea. Like they have trading.
Yeah. That's it.
All right, off topic, off topic, off topic. Back to the Jordan
documentary. We don't fuck with half the countries that we get things from. All right, back to the shit. Who's next?
Sorry, Shane.
I believe you, Shane. I didn't know.
I know. Jim,
you're
talking
about like. Yeah, Shani, you were kind of delayed. I didn't know if you were going or not.
It's not the Wi-Fi. I was just talking like that. I was
like
just talking like that. I'm being dead ass.
It said, yeah.
He said, yeah. Oh, shit. My shit late. Back to the topic.
My bad.
That's too stupid.
Shani, you do sound like you kind of like falling.
Yeah,
but you be all right.
Stupid, bro.